Yeah, how are you?
Hopefully, I mean, it's going to come to life, I think. Is that you guys have to get a full team? Or?
Oh, which
You can basically declare rap if you've got 8 players. But it's kind of hard to do a... It doesn't even go that easy because Tri-City had enough with the 3 players back to make another team. So then once you get 3 players back, how do you do it? So, that the players are all on the Birmingham Association and not have to depend on
the
team. If you have to depend on someone else to make a team, then you need to basically not declare it as well.
Are there, all the Birmingham girls skating in Birmingham, or is they, you know, some of them close enough that everyone's kind of like spread out?
About 5, 6 players that are legitimately on that team. Everyone else is on that.
Oh, really? That's everyone.
Of the whole 05 year in Burnaby, you got 4 players that are 05.
Yes, that's tough.
Yeah.
Some actors you don't bother auditioning because you know they're going to do good. It's like you're not going to audition like, I don't know, what, you know, just like
movie. Yeah, I got a movie.
That's just like Lachlan, right?
I don't know.
That would be the ultimate theory, yeah. Yeah, that would be good. I mean, technically, Colton could be on Carter's team if he makes the rep team, but I don't think so.
Never say never.
Yeah, I'm not worried about that. I mean, what's...
Yeah. But you guys would be okay if both of them are in different rep teams, right?
I mean, my dream is that they play in the same team and the same, you know, this year they could legally or technically, but unless Carter, you know, drops down to Howard. Very good. So there goes our early morning coffees, by the way. So much for opening the door and being able to sneak over. And Connor, I guess. And then A2, probably Carter and that's just my situation.
I think there is a real distinction between being goalies. This one is very slow and then there's no middle ground and then you have to set
the other end. I don't even know who's your goalie this year or the past year?
Yeah, we got Jacob and we've got the other kid.
The Thomas kid. Did he end up playing for the rest of the year, or what happened?
He left.
He left?
He left at the house. So it was all dependent on his
role. On Jacob.
For the whole season. He did rest, right? We did have some at the alternate times. We did bring up what's in Kira.
Oh, Kira, right. With his
daughter. But she is... Basically, she's playing up, right? So other than that, we have no one.
So how's Jacob?
He has his on and off days.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you all about on and off days. You want to talk about on and off days? But all that ice time though, I'm so grateful for him. Like, you know, being the only goal, it's a lot of pressure, but it's tons of ice time.
It's
like a house. Yeah, if you could have Ozzy back then. He actually played up on Sam Carter and Mitch play, so Raj and Sam got I think he did better than Carter. They probably think they did the wrong choice.
He can be effective if he keeps his stick in front of the net instead of behind the net.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely the
Wallace.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I never stand next to Wallace because he takes everything. He's like,
it's like, as you were saying.
Yeah. To a couple, like not to the whole team, or only to a couple.
Oh yeah.
And I wouldn't say it's a regular season when I'm talking about the
give him a high five, sure. What school did she go to?
Burnham North.
Burnham North, oh, okay.
The only... So basically with the hockey academy, it takes away the hockey and one alternative. And it's on the, like, the, it goes every alternate day, it's hockey academy, because it's part of the school courses. So, after lunch, there will be a bus that takes them from school with their hockey gears and whatnot, drop them off here. The only thing is, we have to come and pick them up. They need a ride home.
Oh, okay. Well, how do, is it, you sort of sign up for that, like, going into grade 8?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. How does it work? Like, you just kind of say you want to go in and they, you have to do a tryout and stuff?
No.
Oh, really?
No. And the whole thing is 8 to 12.
Okay. Do they have French there too, do you know?
Do we have French here?
Yeah, French.
Oh, French?
French
Not immersion. Oh. But, so Jaden was from a French immersion school, so she is now in grade 9 English.
Okay.
And they've got a program right now that when, or they are hoping to get it up and running next year, that when kids, because Jaden will be free, she then will be able to actually, they will try and organize it with local schools that she can go in and help a teacher do French courses or French class to help them.
Okay, wow. Oh, and so, is that for her volunteer hours, right?
Volunteer hours as well as a part of her to keep up her French.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah. So, okay, sure.
Do they, is the hockey academy in Washington going to be north, or can they go to other schools too?
They can go to other schools, but the only thing is the bus only takes them from.
Okay.
We got one kid that actually comes from Mountain, but the dad, you've seen him before, he raft out games before. The long, I call him Santa Claus.
Oh,
Mike Richards.
Oh, Mike, okay. That's taking it.
So his son, Sean, is at Burnaby Mountain, but Mike works from home, so he can go grab him, take him here, bring him back, that's it. And as I say, you've got Karen Koss coming in, you got Murray, that I can't remember what's his last, the goalie coach, Murray, the one from Burnaby. Jacob knows them. Anyway, he's a goalie coach, so he's in there. Then there was Jay something or other. But good. As I say, Jaden's shots has improved. It's hard. And I'm playing with the grade 12s. It's like, the funny thing is, the boys can't hit her, but she can go as hard as she works on the boys.
Why not, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. safe. Thank you.
basically sleeping, or do you want?
Safe.
I guess I'm gonna fill up.